Monty Game is like a baby KD with Kevin Garnett mentality.
6'9", versatile, can shoot the three ball, underrated defender, just long and athletic.
Tough to guard. Put it straight like that. There's nothing else to say but tough to guard. That's a bucket.
Right now on the come up, lately been talking about stuff because I know I come from the gutter. Then I go pop out in all of this linen like I was a baller. How can you hate me? I'm coming from under, nowhere to sleep. Now I pop out in ballistics, they run us, man, tell us I'm tweaking. I was down bad, I know I done it all. I was serving the fiends, let it dissolve. If I got a problem, I'm making one call. While none of your people be sliding at all. But like an oven, I'm packing that heat. Only get up with when it's in the sheets. Run to the paper like I'm in a me, baby. Get on your knees, let me give you a treat. Too much of the walkie be having me sleep, but too much of the got me ready to grinding for months, I've been grinding for weeks. My uncle told me to just watch for the week, cause they like to sleep.
Welcome to the spot, man. Ypsi Prep. You know, this is where we just get the work done. Go to school. Let's go. It's my boy, Big Juicy. That's his nickname right there.
What's up?
Big Juicy. He don't What's like up? It, but we just call him that. But you straight, man. You doing your work. You good? What you on, the essay?
No, a little lab report.
Lab report.
Might do.
You almost finished. He lying. We okay. It's okay. We on to my boy Vaughn, man. Vaughn! Oh, we call right there. Rich people, man. So, man, this is my boy, man. He get the work done. You want your work done? This is my man right here. This is my boy Wop, man. We know the name. We know Wop. You straight, fool? What shit you got done today? That's nothing. That's light for my boy Walk, man. We go. That's light day. We got little MJ, little young tender. That's what we call a little young tender. Yeah, that's you. My young bull. You straight? What class you of? Oh, a little geometry, mathematics, added up. Come on now. You straight though? Hold up. We got 2P, purple jumpsuit, Barney. You know what it is. You already know what it is, man. It won't even need no introduction. I'm sorry. Look at the feet, though. Y'all don't even peep the feet work. Boy, guys, tremendous footwork. We not even gonna talk about it. Then my boy, Money, man. Lil Slim Jim. My boy, little Kit Kat. If you got Kit Kat, man, don't come around him. And my boy Bean, though.
Yeah.
Little Kamara Bean. Little Freak Elite. We ain't gonna talk about it. We forgot the main character. My boy Barson. We call him Barson, man. Man Carson, but. Won't mess. We ain't gonna talk about that. Little Barson. You straight? See, he on the different classes. He on the college class and all that, so smart man, he always thinking.
We get up by around, we gotta be here at 9, so we get to school, we gotta go in the classroom for a little bit, from 9 to like 12. We go to lunch. After we go to lunch, we have like a shoot around, like, you know, for lunchtime, and then we come back and we finish our school day. And then after that, we got practice. Usually, but on Tuesday and Thursday, we usually got like weight training, but we ain't been having it lately because we've been playing. So like we just been practicing and stuff and having open gym, stuff like that.
Our situation is unique here. We kind of created our own little bubble. So we're on the back wing of the school. We have a classroom here. We practice here. Sometimes we do yoga here, strength train here. So we have a unique situation. We have our 13-guy roster, and you know, it's great for us because, you know, we're around each other each day. We have two team houses, not located too far from here, roughly about 10 minutes apart. So we pretty much, we're our own little tribe right now.
What made me want to come to Ypsi Prep? Better competition, bigger stage, grow as a man, and mature myself.
And it's more competitive. Well, ranked players I play against on each and every day basis, it's iron sharpens iron, so it helps me get better and I make them better as season goes on.
It was just like heartwarming when you first come here. You were like accepted by everybody. It's no like type of fake love or anything, so that's what I liked about it here.
You know, when you have a talent like Emoni, someone that, you know, he doesn't need an alarm clock. He wakes up ready, he's passionate, and, you know, that really motivates him to go out and compete at whatever he does. Really what we want to do is just highlight his skill set. We also want to then try to take him out of his comfort zone a bit, introduce some new movements, things that are going to help him elevate his game, but yet not necessarily throw his movement off of whatever already has made him successful.
He literally can pull up wherever, and it's literally impossible to stop. And I don't think anyone's ever stopped in practice yet. But we're gonna hopefully someone can step up.
Well, the first time I ever saw Monty, he was in the sixth grade in a gym in Toledo. I was called one of my good friends, Tony Kennard, who's like a brother to me, Coach Bates, and he told me that they were working out. And I walked in the gym, and at that time I was with an AAU program out of Ohio, and I see this lanky, long, athletic kid, and immediately, as he starts to work out and you see the skill set, I immediately called one of my guys who works with the shoe organization, I won't say, with the Swoosh, and I said, this dude's gonna be special. But at that time he was a sixth grader, and fast forward to our first workout here. You know, what's amazing about Emoni is no matter what situation, whenever we have a first of anything, a first practice, a first new kid come into the program, he immediately lets them know by his play that I'm the alpha dog. And you don't see that normally in kids nowadays. A lot of times, a lot of these kids want to be friends. Yeah, they're friends, they're brothers, but when it comes to in between those lines, Emoni clearly lets them know that I'm going to show you why I am who they say I am.
I mean, yeah, off the court, I'm a chill dude. People don't really know me. You know, everybody think I'm mean because of how I am on the basketball court. So it's like when I'm on the court, I mean, it's business on the court. I'm just trying to win. And that's just my competitive side come out. Well, my game is like, I'm gonna go out there and play my hardest every game and like try to give them my all. So whatever I can do to help my team win, that's what I'm gonna do for real. Everybody competitive, I mean, everybody's supposed to make everybody better. And that's what we do, we all try to make each other better. So if we can compete and get better extra reps, and that's what we gonna do.
What'd you say the hardest part of being Emoni Bates?
Being Emoni Bates, because everybody, it's like people forget I'm human. You know, I got feelings like everybody else, so it's like I gotta move a different way because it's just, I'm known, but I'm a human being still, and that's what people tend to forget.
Your teammates were joking around and they were like, you don't even like talking about the number one ranking, or you don't like talking about it.
I don't even like being ranked. Me personally, when I like having fun wise, is when I wasn't famous. And like, feel me, I started getting famous, it was like the love for the game started going away for real. Well, like, I had to learn how to make fun for it again.
We're about to get do a little interview with Emoni in here.
Hey,
you want to pretend to be him? All right, go ahead.
How about you? I know he'd be like this a lot.
Hey, how does it feel to be the number one player in the country? He would not say that. He'd be like, I don't give a fuck. I'm none of that shit. Because they ain't feeling me yet. They don't feel me soon, bro. This school used to be Roberto Clemente. I mean, we used to play basketball here years ago. We used to have open runs and whatnot. And now we're partnered up with Arbor Valley Academy and Ypsi Prep. So that's how this thing came to light. You know, we got the accreditation through Arbor Valley. Now we're here. We got Ypsi Prep running, but that's our education partner. You know, they do the whole education component of Ypsi Prep. School actually came to mind about, I want to say around my next freshman year. Just the thoughts of being able to do something on a national schedule. You know, also as far as safety reasons and things of that nature, you know, you're a highly, you know, talented kid. You're playing competition, well, lesser competition at times. And, you know, when you your dominance sometimes tends to get the best of, you know, the opposition. And, you know, things start to happen as far as, like, guys playing dirty, trying to undercut him, throwing basketballs at his head and things of that nature, to where every night you, as a parent, you have to worry about what's gonna happen tonight, or who's gonna try to do something to try to get into his head, or also potentially harm him. So, I mean, that was pretty much why we kind of figured we need to do something different and put him on the national schedule, to where he could play better competition and also continue to grow and develop as a player.
Well, me and my family, like, you know, decided to, like, get our own prep school. I thought it was a good idea for me, especially, like, competition-wise, be able to play against all the top players in the country and, like, travel against the world. I think it was just a good idea, especially coming from me having a great season in my sophomore season in my old high school. Just going at something different and, like, playing against better players and better competition, I feel like it was best for me at the time.
Yeah, Ball Boy is an apparel line. It's not sports-specific. It's for basketball, football players, tennis, whatever. But it's pretty much for every kid who loves a ball. I think that was seventh grade. We were at a Park Ridge facility working out. Then we captured a couple pictures of him doing two ball drills. And we actually captured that image. And that's actually the logo for Ypsi Prep. And it's also the Ball Boy logo.
Speak about how cool it is coming every day to practice and seeing yourself, your image at half court every night, every day.
Really, seeing myself on the court is like, I don't really look at it like that. It's just like, I'm coming to play basketball in the gym for real. I ain't really looking at it like my teammates, we all coming in here to get better for real.
This is my guy Beam, man. Little ugly dude.
The cutest on the team, for real.
Yo. Nah.
Yeah, man. That's my two kids I ain't got.
Hey, B. Hold on, B.
Bean, he funny, of course. He the team person, funny. Like me, Vaughn, I done been Vaughn my whole life, so it's like, we know how to make each other laugh whenever.
I can't believe that I met you before, bro. Like, this is crazy. Can I get an autograph? Like, right here? Ganger.
We got a song to drop it tomorrow. Somebody told me I saw like Andrew yesterday. So I had to get him to sign their name and everything.
No, Sean funny, he's just a goose. He always wanted to like make everybody laugh, make everybody happy. And like, you know, he always keep a smile on his face, so he like real funny too.
If y'all can smell his breath, oh God, y'all will leave the room. Oh my God. No BS, I'm telling you.
They got big stink in the room.
Hey, listen. Zoom into his sneaks.
Oh yeah.
Zoom into him.
He got the calico boots.
I gotta switch him.
I'm really like an Instagram model. You feel me? Looking at me, you cute, yeah.
Nah.
Oh yeah, what you gotta do?
That's crazy, they hacked my boy.
As a father watching Emoni play, it's not really no proudest moment for me. I think what makes me the most happy inside is when I'm able to see him having fun, able to see him smile on the court, able to know that he's enjoying what he's doing and not having to worry about everything else.
10 years down the road, doing whatever he chooses to do, whether it's basketball, whatever venture he goes into, he's gonna be want to be one of the best, because that's inside of him. He wants to be the best in everything he does. So if he's on the basketball court and he's in the NBA, God bless, he'll be continuing trying to be one of the best that's ever done it, because that's what the kid does.
So. Have you like begun to like picture in your head, you know, what Emoni Bates will be like or where you want to be at in 5, 10 years from now?
Wherever God take me, for real.